Dr. Alan Poole McLard. I am a film studies professor and a filmmaker in my own right. Today, it's the beginning of a new film, an homage to the band Alice in Chains on the occasion of the release of their new record, The Devil Put Dinosaurs Here. Of course, we're going to be interviewing all four members of Alice in Chains. I mean, that's a given. It's just a matter of my assistant getting those interviews scheduled. But in the meanwhile, we're going to go out and interview musicians who have been influenced by Alice in Chains. Stan, hey, Alan Poole McLard. It's nice to meet you. I think we spoke on the phone, exchanged a few emails. You're obviously a huge fan of Alice in Chains.
No, I'm not.
Well, you answered my posting on an Alice in Chains fan board.
I was only on there to be ironic. It's ironic.
Oh.
Yeah, you don't get irony.
As you know, as I explained to you on the phone, we're doing a film about the band Alice in Chains.
We don't know this group.
You've never heard of Alice in Chains?
Nah, man.
William Duvall, the lead singer of this band, his mother used to take him to Jamaica. He says that you were indeed a big influence on him. How did you first hear of the band Alice?
We have one song that tonight I made.
Do you mean Man in a Box? You mean the lyric from Man in a Box?
Well, you know, I wouldn't say that I was introduced to the sound of Alice in Chains. I'd say that Jerry Cantrell fella's been introduced to me. I'd say about 75% of the material from that band is from me. About 1985, he was at every one of my shows. That kid followed me around all summer.
So Jerry Cantrell followed you?
That's
around?
Right. That's right. I'm a big influence of his. You know that song Man in the Box?
Yeah.
That was about me, being on some hard times, you know? It used to be
called Man in a Box.
It was called Man in Hawk. I'm the man in Hawk. I had to sell my shit.
They sold 10 million albums here in this country. 10 million albums. Oh. I mean, that's a lot of records.
Look this year.
Yeah.
$10 million.
Okay, the new record. First of all, the title, the Devil Put Dinosaurs Here. What's that mean to you?
Well, that's just a fact. The Earth's only 6,000 years old.
Seriously?
The devil put the dinosaurs here to fool you.
I like the devil. Dinosaurs are shit.
Well, you're gonna like this. You are gonna like this. Dig this.
I don't like it. I already don't like it.
You already don't like it? You haven't listened to it.
I already know I don't like it. You can turn it off. I already know I don't like it.
Huh?
Familiar, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And he was trying to tell me something. He said, that son of a bitch done did it again. Cantrell ripped me off again. God damn it.
It's a huge hit. It's a huge hit on radio. A funny story that the band didn't even intend this to be a single. No, this is like a deep track cut that was accidentally leaked. So what do you think?
Him sounds sick.
Well?
Like he got a bellyache. It sounds like a bunch of yelling and screaming. What you say the name of the song?
It's called Hollow.
They should have called it How Low.
How Low?
So negative.
I don't personally listen to anything that's not exclusively on vinyl or that sold more than 5,000 records. Like stupid.
Then why are you here?
I'm here to promote my blog, Fixies and Cuffs. It's about fixed geared bikes and pant cuffs.
Shit, I just fucking remembered. It's his fucking birthday.
Whose?
Man here. You seen that movie with Richard Harris, right? A Man Called Horse?
Yes.
Well, this is a horse called Man. Elvis is gonna have a little birthday party for him.
Oh, yeah, look at that, buddy. Huh?
Woo!
Happy birthday, buddy. Oh, yeah.
We can't sing happy birthday.
We're gonna sing happy birthday.
No, I don't have clearance. It's a copywritten song, and it's very expensive to use.
Hell, you think I'm worried about copyrights? Shit, people been ripping me off for years. Let's sing it, goddammit. And many more. Yeah, buddy. Woo-hoo-hoo. There we go. Yeah. Woo. Yeah, buddy. Whoa. We're good. Come on, get down, dude.
Velvet Hammer Management.
Yes, Alan Poole McLard.
Alan who?
Yeah, I'm calling about the...
Hold, please. Yeah.
Yes, sure.
Velvet Hammer Management. Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, Alan Poole McLard, yes. Yeah, I'm calling about the Alice in Chains film. Calling... Hello?
Capitol Records?
Yeah, I've got a meeting about the film. It's Jerry Cantrell calling me. Keep it rolling, I'll put it on speaker. Hello?
Jerry Cantrell calling back for...
Yeah.
Alan Poole McLard.
McLard, it's with a D. Yeah.
I don't know how the fuck you got my number, dude, but I'd sure appreciate it if you stopped calling.
Thank you.
I was in a band back in the day.
Oh, yeah? What was the band?
The band was Back in the Day. I was in a band back in the day. The name of the band was Back in the Day.
What is your band? And what kind of music do you play? You vomit.
Randy.
Oh, fuck.
Take out the trash.
People write about what they want to write about. You know, I like to sing about America, about God, country, you know. I like to sing about my grandma going to jail. You know, things that mean something to me.
Me only sing righteous music. Me only sing about the ocean, the sky, the fruit on the tree, the natural thing, you know. Music should uplift the people. You want to smoke? Me only sing righteous lyric, you know. If I and I were to sing this lyric, I have to change the words, you know? Like I'm more like a... Hollow in the mountain. Got a place to lay my head.
Alice in Chains.
Alice in Chains have a new record coming out.
They're still together?
Oh, fuck yeah, they're still together.
Alice in Chains. You know, it's an event. It's not even a rock band. It's a lot of spitting.
I can't wait for your new record. Hi, guys. What's up? Sean, call me back sometime. You never call me back. You never call me anymore.
This is the proper length for a cuff. If anything less than that's for dicks.
Hollow in the mountain.
Jerry and William together just, you know, really set this oral tone.
Mike Inez, though, I don't know, he's a real troublemaker. He's always getting into trouble, trying to get me into trouble, too.
wasn't for Alice, probably wouldn't be Marilyn Manson, Slipknot, maybe Nine Inch Nails.
I love Alice in Chains, always have loved Alice in Chains.
But there's a new Alice, trust me, there's a new Alice.
I can't wait to hear it.
It's coming. Yeah.
That's very exciting news.
That's very exciting. Cool. Talking about
ocean. You know, Alice Cooper invented himself in 1969 in Detroit, and still going strong to this day.
We're talking about Alice in Chains, not Alice Cooper.
You're talking about who?